Hello friends, today we will see MRI defectogram, or we can call it MRI proctogram as well. So these are the main indication why we do MRI defectogram. First is descending perineum syndrome, second is obstructed defecation, third is difficulty in passing motion, that is stool, then pelvic floor dysfunction or not able to pass complete motion. So mainly it is done when patient is not able to pass motion or he has a complaints of partially passing of stool, mainly because of descent in pelvis floor. Okay, for doing defecography, these are the preparation we required. First, patient has to take tablet Dulcolax one day prior to the scan to cleanse the bowel, so bowel should be clear. Second, patient has to be nil by mouth overnight. In case of patient having any diabetes, he can take a coffee. Third, patient should wear a diaper. So while doing defecation, patient should not contaminate his clothes. Fourth, previous reports are required. If a patient having like barium enema, CT scan, abdomen or pelvis, or previous MRI of pelvis or blood investigations. And the last is, patient has to give a written and explained consent. And things we require for MRI defecography, we require infant feeding tube of size 16 for adult, water soluble jelly at least 250 ml which used in sonography, 50 cc syringe and pair of gloves. Okay, this scan is done in two phases. First is plain scan, where we take plain scan in three planes, axial, coronal, sagittal. And second phase is after passing water soluble jelly into the rectum, just like we do the barium enema. But here we use water soluble jelly. The scan is done in three types. First is rest, which is relax. Second is squeeze, just like holding the motion, just like when patient is holding his motion, or you can say squeezing the abdominal and buttock muscles. And the third is strain, which is giving pressure but not passing the stool. Same, we call it Valsalva maneuver. And the last is defecating, that is a dynamic scan where a patient has to pass water soluble jelly, and same time we have to dynamic scan, which is called a defecating scan. Okay, this is the protocol we have taken: triple localizer, then BTFE satch. Then rest sequences, this is T1 rest, T2 rest, T2-weighted axial and T2-weighted coronal. So as we have discussed, the scan is done in three types. First is rest, and then after passing water soluble jelly, we will discuss it later. First we will see the without injecting water soluble jelly. This is plain scan. You can see the planning here. This is BTFE. So we can take it as a movie sequence. This is like a movie sequence. We can see the pelvis floor of the patient dynamically. can see the planning of BTFE SAGE. Then T1 REST. T2 weighted SAGE. See T2 weighted axial. Reference line we have taken is rectum. You can see we have acquired it through rectal. Rectal is our reference line. You can see perpendicular to the rectum. And the last one is coronal, perpendicular to the rectal. And now we will see the second phase of the scan, which is the water soluble jelly. You can see here in sagittal plane we have injected the water soluble jelly into the rectum at least 250 ml. You can see it in movie format as well. You can see the pelvis floor muscles. And you have to take it in rest, squeeze and strain, all three phases. You can see here you have taken it rest, squeeze and strain. These are the three important aspect of the scan. I am repeating it again. You can see it here, rest, squeeze and strain. I have already discussed what is rest, squeeze and strain. You have to take it in all three plane in sagittal. You can see here how the rest goes, how the squeeze. You can see difference between rest, squeeze and strain. I'll show you. This is rest. This is squeeze. And this is strain. You have to see it repeatedly to see the difference between rest, squeeze and strain. And the last is defecating. You can see the patient is passing water soluble jelly, and you can see the jelly here. And this is the dynamic scan. You might see a little disturbance in the images. That is because of patient is passing motion, or you can see it passing jelly. And same time you have to acquire the scan. That is called a defecating scan, which is very important, and you have to be prepared not to lose the sequence. Or you can see, or you can take two defecating scan. And lastly you can take postoid, that is after completing scan you can see the residual of